introduced to the ICU, we will describe some of the typical equipment that you may see. Visitors have expressed that a basic understanding of our most used equipment helps to reduce their anxiety and gives them a better understanding of the care being provided.
The physiologic monitor shows the patient's vital signs. The large and small monitors show the same information. The smaller monitor is portable and will travel if a patient needs to leave the unit for tests. The patient will be connected to this monitoring equipment while they are in the ICU. This screen may be different depending on the needs of the patient, and the nurse will notify you if there is a significant change occurring. The vitals on the screen are also displayed in multiple places around the ICU so that nurses can easily monitor all patients. Nurses in the ICU can be assigned to more than one patient, and they're able to see another patient's vitals throughout the unit and while they're in another patient's room. There are different alarms in the ICU. All staff are trained to differentiate and respond to the alarms. Please do not touch any of the equipment. Use the call light if you have questions or concerns about the alarms. The IV pumps deliver fluids and medication. If the IV pump is beeping, please do not touch the pump. Press the call light to alert your nurse. Sequential compression devices wrap around the legs and squeeze the calves to promote blood flow back to the heart and help prevent blood clots from forming while lying in bed. Arterial lines measure the blood pressure by directly inserting a catheter into the artery. As the heart beats, the equipment will translate the blood pressure into a waveform, which the treatment team will monitor. An ICU patient often has many types of lines or tubing, which are used for treatment of medical problems. The staff will be happy to explain what they are used for. If you notice the patient has intentionally or accidentally pulled or removed any of their lines, immediately notify the nurse. When the line is in the groin, please do not move the head of the bed up because this can cause the line to kink inside the body. Some patients' conditions cause them to be sensitive to position changes, so first check with the nurse before you change the bed settings. BiPAP and CPAP machines use masks to deliver pressurized air into the airways to help the patient breathe better. This may feel uncomfortable if they're not used to it. Encourage them to wear the mask as long as they can. Ventilators help assist with the patient's breathing. The respiratory therapists will monitor and adjust the settings to ensure enough breathing support. Some patients may be given medication to help them sleep or relax, so they may not be able to respond to you. Other patients may be alert and can communicate their needs with pen and paper. Encourage these patients to write instead of trying to read their lips over the tube in their mouth. In the event of a medical emergency, additional equipment may be brought into the room. We're happy to address any questions after the situation is stabilized.
We understand that having a lot of equipment in the room can be overwhelming, but we are here to help you understand the role of the devices. So please feel free to ask if you have any questions.